Lynn, you were destined to be one of our truly big winners.
I was.
You waited a very long time to have the chance to come to the Dream Factory.
I did.
You stood over there in the East Wing watching other people succeed, some fail, and some take the middle road. Yours was never going to be the middle road. You were destined to win life-changing money. Oh. Oh, yeah, come on, what do I want to know? She turned down 7, and then you added 10. She took that at 17, and then, yeah, because of that incredible round, you then added another 10. So 27 would have been the last one, yeah? This is worth just thinking about because we do get these totally bizarre occurrences on this show.
Mm-hmm.
7,000 you declined. It rose 10,000 to 17,000, which you accepted.
Mm-hmm.
It rose to 27,000.
No,
going up in tens, right?
Right, yeah.
And then what he would have done at this point, I find this extraordinary. You have created exactly the same finish as Tegan, the wonderful Tegan, who had 20,000 and a quarter of a million and went for it and became number 4.
Right.
Her offer at this point was exactly what he would have offered you. And he's just realised the coincidence.
Mm-hmm.
Because he would have upped the 27 by a factor of 50,000. £77,000.
Wow.
And he said, I've just realised it. He said, I'm playing with honesty. I would have increased the 27 by 50,000. Oh, that is, coincidentally, what he offered Tegan.
Yes. I understand that. No way can
Tegan, the wonderful Tegan, she's only 21 years old. She was in remission from cancer, and she was our number 4, our most recent quarter millionaire. And now, here we go. It's quite a moment because you'd think you'd be able to relax and in the back of your mind be thinking, I've got 17,000, everything's all right, can't wait to take it home to Jeff and have a laugh and whatever. But we always say the worst thing to take from the Dream Factory is an ounce of regret.
Mm.
And the thought that you could, after all the hard work you've had over the years, have gone home to Jeff with a quarter of a million.
Wow.
That is quite a thought. Was that what was about to happen to you? Should you be number 5?
Who would have thought it?
That was your destiny.
Who would have thought it? Oh.
What an amazing game.
I know.
Oh, Scott, please, second time this week.
Yes.
Second time this week.
Yeah. I was hoping it would be that in there, actually.
Well, that would have made you feel
it would have
considerably
feel
better.
Okay.
I mean, it is extraordinary that it's happened twice
within
5 games.
5 times since I've been here.
Yeah. We get these big money periods and we then get people that turn their back on the money.
I know, and I'm sorry, but that's the way I read the game.
Yeah. Now.
And I'm so happy. I'm disappointed, but I'm happy.
Well, let's have the deal.
No regrets.
Let's have the deal, but you did not win as a player, but as Lynn, you've certainly won because you have £17,000.
I have.
How does that
feel?
Enjoy it.
I will.
Give my best to Jeff.
I will. Thank you.
What a week. What an incredible week. Yes, quarter of a million coming to the table. And then that extraordinary Bill Bailey game where he got 30,000 with the 100,000 dominant in the game. Unbelievable. And we're not finished yet. Sunday, more celebrations for the banker's birthday. See you then.